For this Rust base build video, I challenged myself to make as small of a base as possible. This is going to be an extremely small form base that has a lot of bang for the buck, but minimal upkeep. It's something for someone who just wants to focus on PvP, doesn't have that much time, or is just getting started in a wipe. This base looks like nothing, but it does have a lot of bang for the buck, so let's get into it. First off, the foundation is going to be one square foundation and one triangle foundation. The triangle foundation is going to be raised about half a wall up. Then you're going to put in your walls, put in a door, and then you're going to put some half walls on that square section. These half walls basically give you one whole square to use as a storage space, and it gives you a lot of bang for the buck, so it's definitely worth the extra upkeep. Now, this is the basic design. We've got it all down. That's it. Put in your doors and you're good to go. The doors here are going to be one single door and one garage door. This is not the best because you're losing out on a lot of the protection that an airlock gives you, but I think the trade-off's worth it because of how small and how compact the space gets to be. So now let's put in the TC that's going to go at the very back, and right next to the TC, you're going to put in your workbench. This is likely going to be a tier 1 or tier 2 workbench. By the time you're tier 3, you're probably not going to be using a base like this. Now what you're going to want to do is drop your boxes in the top section. You can store 4 large boxes up here, but it's a little hard to get them in. I probably should have done something like this, looking back, where you have 2x1, but in the end, I went with a different layout for these boxes. I sort of do regret it, but it is what it is, and this was just an example. You can sort of lay this out however you want, but basically, you should be able to get at least 3 large boxes and 1 small box in here, and if you're really good, you should be able to get maybe 4. Yeah, probably 4 large boxes. One nice thing about not having that small box there and not putting it down right away is you can just jump right up into this section of your base to pull loot from the boxes. Personally, I'd prefer this and only put down the small box if I needed it. So you can see right here, I just jump up and bing, bang, boom. Just like that, I get access to all 3 boxes. Now, let's start talking about that bottom section. So this is sort of a very basic layout for the bottom section, but it can be done better. You can put down a blueprint table right here. Before putting a box under the blueprint table, what you're going to want to do is lay down your sleeping bag. Put your sleeping bag right here next to the blueprint table, and then under the blueprint table, you can put one large box. Now off to your left, you're going to be able to put down a furnace, just like so. And if you really did everything correctly, you should also have room for one small box right here. And that's it. That's pretty much the base build, just like that right there. But there are a few little changes and tweaks that you can make depending on what you're looking for. You can see, though, very small, very compact base. It gets the job done. And a lot of people aren't going to bother raiding it because it looks utterly ridiculous. So here's what you can do. If you need a little bit of extra space in this square, this airlock section, you can put one small box, or if you want to get really ridiculous with it, you can drop down a furnace. But yeah, that's it. That's a small base build. There's not really much you can do with it other than this layout, but it gets you your blueprint table, gets you your workbench. It gets you at least 4 large storage boxes, possibly 5, with 2 additional small storage boxes. And that should be enough for anyone who's looking for some sort of PvP bunker or something they can just loosely play out of in a wipe that they're really not looking to spend that much time in. So yeah, that's my minimalist Rust base build. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you hit the like button. And if you like the fact that I didn't pad this out or put any BS in there, hit subscribe because it does help my channel and I'm trying to get to 100,000 and would really appreciate it. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, peace.